ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to today's senior football championship game between Sarnia Northern and Sarnia St. Pat's in the LKSSAA championship game here at Alex Field at Norman Perry Park. I'm Jim Bell along with Selwyn Jordan, and we're looking forward to a pretty interesting game. Selwyn to talk to the teams before the game, and head coach Mike Adams from St. Pat said he's very excited and anxious. He kind of says they're not better than them. It's just kind of more psychological. But Northern's a heck of a program.
Absolutely, they're a heck of a program, and both teams seem like they're doing it the Patriot way. They're not wanting to be announced, and they just want to come out and have their team introduced as a team. So, wow, great atmosphere here. Got a good set of fans who are on our side, and we got in the booth here. We have couple people.
St. Pat's has won the coin toss and they defer to the second half. St. Northern football will be kicking off once we get this one started here. We just got done watching this junior championship. It was a 43-44 victory for St. Pat's over Northern. I'm hoping it's going to be a little bit of a closer game today.
Oh, I'm sure it'll be. I'm sure it will.
Head coach Dave Elsley out there. Great football man. And Craig Davies from Northern is just phenomenal too. The programs have just been two of the most elite.
Really enjoyed watching both of them play throughout the year, and this is going to be an excellent game.
We're hoping so anyway. So we're just about ready to kick it off, and we're going to get things going. So what other things do you expect from today's game?
You know what? I think there's going to be a lot of running. The weather seems perfect for any kind of, you know, air attack, running attack, but I think Northern's going to want to keep the ball on the ground. They have some great athletes in the backfield. The quarterback is excellent, and their two running backs. And St. Pat's, I think they might do the same. If we see the ball in the air, it'd probably be St. Pat's a little bit more.
I think so. I think St. Pat's is going to have to air it out. St. Pat's is going to have to really attack Northern and jump on them. And I really think it comes down to mistakes. If whatever team's going to make the most mistakes, which sounds so clichéic, but at the same time, I think the mistakes are going to be heightened with St. Pat's because St. Pat's has got it in their mind. This is Northern. They're playing is Northern. It's, you know, the north end of the city and blah, blah, blah. And, of course, we all know that St. Pat's and St. Chris have amalgamated this year. So we're going to get ready for kickoff here.
Yeah, I think it's always mind games within mind games because these teams have seen each other for so many years. These players know each other extremely well. So it's a game plan within a game plan.
Yeah, Trevor McEwen is back to receive the kick for the St. Pat's Irish as Blake Maxfield tees it up. Referees are ready, and we're about ready to get this thing started. Blake Maxfield with the kickoff. Onside kick. Recovered up there. Jumped on by 59. 59, Sam Ellner with the recovery of the onside kick. They tried to catch him off right back.
Yeah, they tried to catch him off guard, and St. Pat's was ready. It looked like he would caught that ball on his heels, actually. But a great play there to recover that.
The front line's got to be so ready to go and just jump on that ball, right? It's kind of I was quite surprised with a kickoff like that from Northern, to be honest with you. So
yeah, you know what? He's going for it. I tell you, both teams are.
Josh Elsley.
So they got a double tight formation here.
Yep, Josh Elsley, the quarterback for St. Pat's, calling out the play. It's some early motion. Josh drops back for the pass. Josh puts it up in the air, a little bit of a wobbly duck, and is knocked down back there by number one, Ramon Bastello.
Yeah, it looked like St. Pat's, they try to flood the zone. They had three receivers go out to the flats, one corner, one out, and the other a short pass, and try to outnumber, but that safety came across and broke that up.
Yeah, so it was to the air. I thought Josh would get a little bit more out of it. Josh has been a quarterback his whole life as well, and he's also got a really nice kick to him. So I was surprised it went right to the air. St. Pat's comes out with a regular formation. Josh in the gun as well. Roll out to the left, to the right. Josh drops the ball back up. It's up in the air. Intercepted by Romain Bastille. Picked off by Northern. First down at the 30-yard line.
You know what? That was a great setup of a play. They got a seal over on the outside on the defensive end. He was able to get outside. He maybe had a chance to run. I don't think he could have ran for a first down, but threw it up, open for a second, and that safety came in there, Bastillo.
I'm totally surprised that they come out putting the ball in the air like that two times in a row. You know, they've got the read option. They always seem to run, and I thought they'd be more protective of the ball being this early in the game, right? You really don't want to turn the ball over very too quick at all. Colby Lundy is a quarterback for Northern. He's up under center. Handoff goes there to Jordan Walsh up the middle for a gain of three.
Yep, after the I would say that was a lot more conservative play compared to the short kick. But, yeah, excellent play there. Still got about 5-6 yards.
That's right. So Jordan Walsh is behind. Mitch Duvall is out here to the far side. Motion Colby Lundy up under center. Colby Lundy ball to Jordan Walsh up the center again for a gain of about 3 yards. He's going to bring up about a third down and one.
Walsh again, the ball carrier. Tackled by number 20, Mitch Damchuk.
I think we're going to be calling Walsh's name quite a bit today.
I think so.
He's their bread and butter.
I think so, yes. Fazio on the tackle for St. Pat's.
It'll be third and one.
Looks like they're going to punt. Again, to be honest with you, I think the flip side of this, the way Northern has been playing around the bat, I thought St. Pat's would come out that way as opposed to throwing it up in the air.
Yep. For the Vikings.
Yeah, a game within a game for sure. They're trying to
Trevor McEwen back to kick out, back to receive Blake Maxfield's punt. Picks it up on the 35, brings it to the 40, breaks up far side, tackle right there. Tackle down by Niels Cruz.
Trevor McEwen of the Irish.
Picked
up by Niles Cruz of the Vikings.
Great return there. Looked like he jogged down a little left and back right. He had that ball out there like a loaf of bread, and I could see why Northern was trying to go and reach for it.
Blake Maxfield is the injured Northern Viking on the field. Again, I'm quite surprised at the start of the game. We've got 9:54 remaining in the first quarter, and I'm very surprised at the game plan that's come into this game already. Like I said, it's a tale of two sides, but I honestly thought the game plans have been reversed. I thought St. Pat's might come out now with a little bit more more ball control and more pressure up the middle and try to utilize that, but never know. I guess maybe Northern's taking it away, and maybe they saw something on tape about being open down the middle. So let's see what they got this time.
Yep, let's see how it goes here. I would be very surprised if it went back into the air. I think they might do a little more ground and pound here.
Josh Housley with the gun.
Northern's got an odd man front, looks like.
Looks like they're bringing the heat as well. Ball control up the middle. Great gain right there.
And the games that I've watched, the St. Pat's, they've been able to run the ball very successfully, and it's almost reversed. They would pass to set up the run, it looked like for me, from what I watched in the past, and there was an example of it, running off tackle and well-executed play.
Mitch Damchuk with that run for the first down for the Irish. Josh Housley back in the gun as well. Back to pass. Might keep it. Gets a mill up the middle. Good gain. Tackled there by 54.
Broken play. Housley takes it himself.
Jared Lippitt on the tackle for Northern.
9 yards on the play. He was wrapped up by Mitch Kutstra.
Housley, very smart player. You can see the size of him there. He looks more like a running back than a quarterback. And did very good things to be able to get 8-9 yards on that play.
He can. He's really good with his feet. He's really good at reading. His father was actually a quarterback out in LCCVI during his high school days.
Okay. Yep.
So he comes from the genes.
Yes.
Some motion coming to this side. Josh Elves up the middle of the Damchuk. Damchuk with a first down run of about 4 yards.
Damchuk.
Now, Jim, you'd say that maybe
the Irish.
St. Pat's maybe 15 pounds, maybe heavier than?
St. Pat's has got a beefier team, and they got the bigger men up front, I guess you could say. Yeah, they probably outweigh them for the whole team across the board, I would imagine that. Yep. But the problem is in the key positions, Northern's very, very, very good and very talented and very deep, and that's the key.
Right. Shotgun here, spread.
Here we go. They're at the middle with Damchuk again. Damchuk carries the ball. enough for a first down, tackled by a whole whack of them. Cody Ramon Bastille in on the tackle, ran for 12 yards for a first down.
Looked like it was going off tackle, and then it came right back into the A-gap, and he just took it. In that formation, to me, looks a lot like a wing T formation, but just in shotgun.
That's right. They normally do that. Like they really pound the ball up the middle all the time with number 20, Mitch Damchuk. Left a little bit of movement on this side. There's a read option for Josh. Josh runs up the middle. Josh Elsley for about a 10-yard gain. Looks like a first down for the Iris. That read option is so good in three-down football. And I think it's so tough to decipher when you've got yourself a running quarterback as well.
Absolutely. And F. Elsley here as an extremely major weapon here. They look like that guard pulled. The lineman blocked down, followed the guard, and then found the crease.
Yep. Josh Elsley out of the gun again. Damchuk with the run off to the left side. Tackled just for enough of a gain. It looks like you got the first down, though. We'll have to see about where the referees will spot that.
See if it's a left foot or a right foot.
Looks like it was a stop. First down, St. Pat's.
Yeah. First down for the Irish. Wrapped up by Vincent Ham of Northern. As well as Jarrett Lippy.
So in the first series, it looked like we were in the air, and now we're back down to the ground, and this is, I think, where St. Pat's is, where their strength is.
So perhaps St. Pat's just tried to catch Northern off guard right off the bat, thinking they're going to put too many men in the box and try to spread it out and pop a few quick ones.
Well, let's see if they hit outside here. They've been really just attacking inside, and Northern playing a five-man line.
Stuff that I've always seen all the time is that's what they normally do, is just all that option in the middle, and Josh with a run. Great big hole. Oh, nice hit. Yes.
Josh Elsley.
Niels Cruz on there.
Niles Cruz.
With a great tackle on Josh on that one.
Great play all around. Excellent run. Elsley there got hit fairly hard, but man, he jumped right back up, ready for action. Great hit there on the play. Nice form tackle. Hit low and was a punishing tackle.
St. Pat's has played Northern twice this year. The first game was 49-10. The second game was 23-0. So I'm thinking that the points on average, 36 average points. So it's first down and 10 for Josh Elsley. First down and 10 for St. Pat's. So coming into the game, Northern, and head-to-head, it's on average in the two games, is 36-5. So I think St. Pat's has to score early to get on the board, to get them out of their game.
Confidence,
Elsley again out of the gun. Hand off to Damchuk. Damchuk up the middle. Damchuk's being tackled right there by number 35.
They give us to Damchuk.
Jeremy Jones on the tackle.
Made by Jeremy Jones.
Yeah, Northern's defense got very stingy there. It looked like that safety's rolled up. They got the two inside linebackers sneaking in. They have a five-man line. They were not going to allow a run that time.
Second and 10. Maybe second and 11. Calling out the signals, Elsley again.
Four-man line, three linebackers.
They're going to drop. Pitch this way. Very nicely designed play around the end.
Oh.
Three with the run. That would be Mateo DeSoni on the run around the left side.
Yeah, you knew it was a matter of time that St. Pat's would have tried to bounce something outside. Looked like there was a slot around, and not sure if there was any guards that pulling, but just barely got to the edge, but ran out of real estate.
Just trying to keep the corners safe, right?
Absolutely.
Keep them honest on the outside like that. Field goal here, 63 St. Pat's. Mitch Humby.
Humby to kick.
Looks like 16-yard field goal. Snap high. Block is punt. Blocked. Jordan Walsh with this, or Mateo Tassoni. Nope, Jordan Walsh. Jordan Walsh by Jordan Walsh.
St. Pat's had a great drive. Probably, obviously, didn't end the way they wanted it. It was a high snap and, a tough angle for a field goal. But St. Pat's got in there, overloaded the left side, and was able to get a block.
That's right. That's really good. It was, the snap was a little bit high. I thought Mitch was going to get his hand into it, but it was an opportunity. So he was able to get that block. So a good turnover early, I guess.
Yes.
I was waiting for Jordan to pick that up and take it all the way back to the house, I guess. But
yeah.
We'll see. So it'll be first down right now. Kobe Lundy. Jordan Walsh. Kobe Lundy back to pass. Pass to 85. Mitch Duvall with the reception. Gain of about 10.
Great pass there by Cody Lundy. I like how he had that ball high.
A safe pass.
Very safe pass, but had that ball high, great mechanics, and found Mitch out there in the flats. Looked like a gain of about 8, 9.
Gain of 8 on the play. It'll be second and 2.
The thing we haven't seen yet is what is in their playbook is Kobe Lundy can run left, can run right, can run center. He can run anywhere he wants to run. He is very, very talented. Read option to Cody Lundy. Cody Lundy up the middle. Good stick. Good stick.
Kobe Lundy takes it himself.
Yeah, Cody Lundy's very tough player. Again, he's built like a running back himself.
Tyler Jackson on the tackle.
Did a great job there getting behind his blockers. Was very patient and found the hole to get a first down.
Majority of the guys on the defensive side are just waiting for that. They're keying on Kobe because Kobe is a runner.
Yes.
Pitch out. Jordan Walsh coming to the side.
Here's another
reading
player.
His blockers.
Yep.
Really nice job. Tackled there again by Jackson.
Ball's given to Jordan Walsh. Tackles made by McCauley and Jackson.
Jordan Walsh there, very patient again, kind of following his blockers.
Down,
wiggled, little left, little right, and was able to get about 7 on it.
Second and 3 come from up here for Northern. Kobe Lundy up under center. Jordan Walsh just off tackle with a big gain up the center. Jordan Walsh for a gain of about 22.
Got a flag on the play, maybe a holding. We'll see.
There is a flag down.
Isn't the funny thing about high school football that they have quarterbacks playing both ways and they have.
Yep.
That bothers me at times.
Now you know what? I wonder if it was unsportsmanlike on the quarterback.
Roughing the quarterback.
Yep.
Rough play called against the Irish.
Look like Sarnia.
Tack on another 15-yard penalty.
Yep.
15-yard penalty.
Sarnia St. Pat's, I think, you know, sometimes with that read option, they probably had a defensive end outside linebacker that's assigned for the quarterback and probably took liberty on him there behind his play.
Well, you got to get your shots on him because once he gets around you, he's gone.
Yes.
Here comes that same play again. It looks like they're going to set up. Kobe drops back. Screen over there, 39. Screen was set up very nicely to Jeremy Jones. Gain of
39, Jeremy Jones.
Gain of about 10.
Tackle made by number 22, John Fazio.
No, I'm sorry. Gain of about 9.
Yeah,
8.
You know what? Great call there. And that was set up very nicely. Craig Davies, obviously, had that place scouted, had that set up. And it was a nice tackle there by number 22.
Well, it's interesting. Like I said, like they've got to respect Kobe so much that they're going to overplay it. So those screen passes really work.
Yes.
Run up the middle again right there by Niles Cruz
carries the ball.
Did he get forward? Yes, enough for the first down. First down for Northern Vikings. As they're moving here, we're under a minute left in the first quarter. Clock is running. We're at 35 seconds.
Niles Cruz, another athlete there for Northern. Great little run. Just needed about 2 to get the first down, and he got it.
Kobe Lundy up under center. Double reverse. There, number 7, Zachary Duxilly around the outside. A flag on the play. Nice block out there by Kobe Lundy as well. Great smack over there. Nice knock out of bounds.
With the reverse.
Josh
Elsley makes the tackle. Flag down.
Great
again,
execution of play.
St. Pat's quarterback with the tackle. It's got to be in
the indication is
a holding.
A holding penalty.
Yeah, just got, I think, on the edge there. It looked like Northern player on the edge. Just got his hands out there, held him up a little too long.
That's what happens in a double reverse situation, right? You guys, so it's such a timing process. You got to just delay it so much.
Right.
So the bigs, I guess you could say, are just got to hold their water, and they can't really grab people.
Yeah, unfortunately there for Doxley, it was a great run. You took shake them inside, went back out. Great blocking around the quarterback there. Lundley was happy to make a block and unfortunately have a hold.
This will be the last play of the first quarter as Colby Lundley's calling out directions. Colby rolls out to his left. He's looking to pass. He might keep it and tuck it. He's going to, oh, good tackle. Good tackle right there. Colby Lundley pushes the ball for about a gain of about 25 yards.
Tackles made by
like that, he had two hands on that ball. Had it on there tight. Had it a little high. Nice tackle, I'd say, there by St. Pat's.
Yes.
There's three or four then that came in, crowd him. But he held on to the ball and was able to fall forward again.
You see them a lot when they make that run like that, when they get Colby, they get their feet chopped and they get so excited because they're just waiting for him to go left or right, and because he's so elusive when he runs.
Yes.
So that's what they're really nervous about. Dale Meisner was a tackle there for St. Pat's. So I don't know. I guess we're 0-0 at the end of the game, end of the first quarter. So at the same time, I think this is right in St. Pat's ball game because they're not in a big hole.
Right.
The game hasn't got too far out of control yet.
Yes. Unlike the eight-man game, this has been a very entertaining game.
Yes, they could have called the eight-man game right at the end of the first quarter, and
yes,
we all could have just stayed warm down on the field, I guess you could say.
Right. Yeah, very well-coached teams. Really happy to see this, see these two teams playing here.
Fantastic programs. The Northern Vikings come into this one 6-0-0. They come in, they've scored 192 points for, only 31 against. So they're averaging 32 points, and they're only averaging giving up 5.1 per game this season. So points aren't going to be easily come by.
No.
So 0-0 is pretty good for St. Pat's right now.
These teams know each other extremely well.
Colby Lundy back for the pass. Nice toss to the far side.
Oh, got it.
Right there.
Nice.
Throw complete to Zach Doxley.
You know, Cody
Zachary
Lund-
Doxley with the tack. With the
Vikings.
Cody Lundy stayed in there and threw that ball, knew he was going to get hit, and delivered a strike.
That's right. Perfect throw. So you got to respect the run, and now he goes and throws it long like that, which was perfect.
Doxley
with the tack, with the reception in the end zone. 6-0 right now for Northern Vikings.
St. Pat's did a great job actually getting through. Didn't get clean, and just gave him enough time to be able to get enough air on that ball. And then Doxley did a great job in recovery.
Josh Graham in for the extra point. 7-0 for Northern Vikings.
Extra point tacked on by Josh Graham. It'll be 7-0 Northern.
Yeah, love to see the coaching both ways. And like there, Craig Davies, you know, changed it up. He could have ran that ball, said he's going to throw it up to his wide receiver. And it was, you know, a great call there in the red zone.
When you get that many kids buying into the system, it's so easy for these coaches to put stuff together. They know they're getting the dedication at practice. They know they're getting the dedication in the weight room, dedication to all their meetings. Both these programs are the upper echelon here in the old LSSAA, which
yes,
is now right. We've added Lambton-Kent Secondary School Athletic Association.
Right,
so,
that's true.
And we needed to do that here in town because without it, Sarnia football would have folded, which is very disappointing.
Right.
Josh Graham with the kickoff. Back to receive the ball for St. Pat's. Oh, nice stick there, nice stick there. Matteo Tassoni on the run.
Bastilli there, I think, on the tackle. It was a great tackle. Nice hit.
Made by Ramon Bastillo.
Ramon is all over the place.
Return made by Tassoni.
Yep, nice play there by Ramon. Nice, I like that play.
So how are they going to answer? How do you think they're going to answer?
Well, we'll see. They had a lot of success running inside and got away from it in the red zone, going outside a little bit. So we'll see.
Their defensive line is outweighed by the St. Pat's offensive line. You think they did that a little bit better and pound the rock. Just pound it up the middle and keep going, because something's going to break outside. One of these kids are going to break it and be gone to open that up. And Josh can throw the ball. Colby can throw the ball. So both quarterbacks can toss the ball. So they got to set that up. But so many people don't set that up. They just keep running, run. You got to run to set up the pass, and pass to set up the run. You got to try to loosen up everybody.
Right. Oh, great run there. You can't complain with 5-6 yards right up the middle on a first down.
No. So Josh Elsley back in the gun. He's got Damchuk to his left. Ball's given to Damchuk. Trips up the middle. He lost his footing. Tackle there. But it's Jared Lippitt on the tackle.
Tough thing with three-down football. It's, you know, that second down so crucial. Needed another four or five. And it looked like it was a good exchange. And Turf Monster just caught his foot. And he tripped up there.
Yes, the Turf Monster gets everybody.
Now screws back for the Vikings.
Now his cruise drops back for the Vikings, and Mitch Humby will be the punter.
See, if he tries to kick it out of bounds, that might be a wise choice here.
Mitch Humby with the punt.
Oh, kicked it right down the middle.
5 yards, nice bounce. Now his cruise picked it up.
Uh-oh.
Comes here to the far side, starts a stutter step, going to take the corner. Oh, going to take it. Oh, that's a little bit of a late. That's a wee bit out of bounds.
Almost certainly a late hit on the play.
Tyler Jackson hit him about, probably about 4 yards outside of the field.
Yeah, it was unfortunate there for Tyler Jackson. I think he was had his momentum.
I don't think these two teams need any kind of gasoline.
No, that's true. No, the last thing he needs is another 15-yard penalty. And that's the second one for St. Pat's. Uncharacteristic for them. Very disciplined team.
15 yards imposed.
And you throw that Catholic thing out there. That's not the Catholic thing to do. Those are two ginormous penalties you're going to take against a team that you don't want to get behind too much because you're not going to be able to catch them.
Yes, correct. I just think that he just kind of lost. Tyler just kind of lost his way on the field and didn't realize how far out of bounds he was.
That's right. Jordan Walsh up the middle for a gain of about 7 yards. Bounces off somebody. Tackled from behind. Great pursuit. He didn't stop going after him. 63.
Tackle made
yep,
by
Mitch Humby.
Mitch Humby, who's also the punter and the place kicker.
Yep, and as a good pursuit there by Mitch Humby. And obviously a great run there by Jordan Walsh. Patient again. Look, was almost used like a fullback there. I think it was kind of a trap. Bounced it out. And
I
then
like the second effort that Mitch Humby come across with. Didn't give up on that run.
Yes.
Tackle them from behind. Jordan Walsh up the middle again, bounces it off. Ripped down there by a couple of the Irish.
Yeah, it's an interesting formation there. Look at three running backs in the backfield. One is just very tight with the O-line. Another one that's full back depth. And then another at tailback depth. So lots of play action, play fakes.
Misdeception.
Yes, absolutely, misdeception. And then and out of that, I'm sure the quarterback can run. So it's a nice set here with Craig.
Kobe Lundy hands it off right there, number four. Now is Cruz around the outside.
Jeez.
Dixon dancing for only a gain of about two.
Cruz. You work.
It's interesting you say that about Kobe. On any other team, Kobe Lundy would be the running back and the guy you go to all the time. Here he's the quarterback. He's the leader. So in a situation, he is the best athlete, short but game, you almost want the ball in his hands on any time of running.
Right. And out of all these plays, Greg obviously has a design boot pass or run with all these plays.
When he was a little bit younger, Kobe Lundy would go sideline to sideline and north to south and east to west, and every single time he touched the ball, it was almost a touchdown. It was insane. Kobe drops it back for a long pass. There, Niles Cruz drops it in the end zone.
Lundy's pass.
Unbelievably right into his hands and Cruz, the attendant receiver, and he drops the ball.
Yeah, it was a great pass there by Lundy. And, you know, Cruz did put on the edge burners, I believe, to make that catch. It was probably a little harder catch than it looked because it was well thrown. He did have to catch up to it and huffing and puffing to catch it and made it there. But it's always hard to catch that ball when it's below your heart.
Josh
Elsley gets back into the receive to the punt here from Northern.
30, Josh Graham.
Very tough, I find, making that basket catch at times.
Blake Maxfield is normal kicker. He seems to be out with that injury.
Oh!
Bomb. Blocked.
Blocked.
Beautiful. Picked up by
63. Picked it up on the ground.
63 with the run back for the touch.
Uh-oh. Here he
goes. Is he going to get caught?
No, he
touchdown.
Made it.
St. Pat's off the block punt.
Jeez.
50.
Blocked by number 40, Miles McLean with a big block.
40 with a huge block.
Mitch Humby.
And
Mitch
looked like an Argo bounce.
Mitch Humby with the Miles McLean with the block, and Mitch Humby takes it back, huffing and puffing because he's a big guy. He's the kicker, the punter, and now he runs back the blocked kick.
Wow. I'm sure we're going to see a replay here, just but
Chubb in there
was a Argo bounce. What
Mitch Kooster tried to catch him down there, but just didn't. Mitch Humby is not fleet of foot, so he had a big of a head start. That was a great turnaround, though.
Oh, excellent. And good effort there by Hundy to be able to run that in.
We just mentioned that Blake Maxfield is a normal punter and a normal place kicker for them, number 10 for Northern Vikings. He's out injured, so now Josh Graham takes over those responsibilities, and we get a turnover of a situation of a block punt that's seven against.
Looks like Humby's still huffing and puffing.
He's not a fleet of foot fella, Mitch Humby isn't.
He'll be good for him.
There's all seven on that play.
Nice going. Play. Great effort by him there.
And Mitch will be looking for the gas.
Strong work there by Humby. Good job. Good. Yeah.
Now he's got a punt. Now he's got a place kick and kick it off. He's tanked. And then play defense.
Yeah, and play defense too, I bet. Great effort there by him.
That's interesting. Like I said, because all of six games Northern's played all year this year, they've only allowed 5.1 points against. So now we're already over that average, right. And there's not many games that they've been in this situation of being tied. All the points that the teams have been getting against them have been late in the game when kind of the scrubs are in, the second guys are in, the Davies is taking his foot off the gas pedal a little bit. So 7-7, I think, is in the favor of St. Pat's, which is interesting because I think they came in with that game plan to keep things close, look for mistakes.
Sure.
Mistake like that.
Yes.
Turnover, points, great.
You know, and just looking at the game with the yardage, this game does deserve to be tied. St. Pat's had a couple good drives, moved the ball into that red zone, was unfortunate, and the defense held up. But, you know, big turn.
Now, Cruz and Ramon Bastillo back to receive the kickoff from a quite tired Mitch Humby, who's done it all the last little bit.
Oh, now he's got to pick up the ball.
And 34 was supposed to be there to be the holder, and he seems he doesn't need to hold the ball. So Evan Medeiros thinks he doesn't need to put his finger on the ball.
At least he could have picked that up after that run.
Mitch is huffing and puffing, and he gets into it.
There he is.
Short kick, 22, is going to pick that ball up.
Yep.
Easton Kaladi with the return. Easton Kaladi kind of trips on his little – oh, we got a little bit of a extracurricular stuff going off to the side here.
Yeah, Easton Kaladi, nice little run there. First and 10. I'm not sure who made that tackle. It looked like it was John Fazio. Yep, good. It was a very good textbook tackle wrapped up around the legs.
Some of these kids are the same age. They've grown up together playing in that SMA program. They keep talking about the Sarnia Minor program. I know you're from the Chatham area for the Chatham Minor program,
Chatham
the Cougars. And I think then the Sturgeons are down here. I think these kids have an opportunity now to play football almost 8 to 9 months of the year.
Yes.
You know, with the fall and the summer program. Fumble.
Oh.
Kobe Lundy with the fumble. This is interesting. After that block
Lundy
of that punt, Northern seems to be a little bit on the rattled side, which might be a bonus for St. Pat's.
Right. Yes, actually, it's uncharacteristic there by Lundy to have a mishap there with the ball. Looked like it was a quarterback run designed for him.
He looked like he was running
before he had it. So.
Oh, yeah.
But credit to him, he was able to, you know, not make a mistake, fell on that ball, and minimize the loss.
So we got 2nd and 15 here. We got 6 minutes and 50 seconds left in the second quarter.
Oh,
Lundy looking
again
for the screen pass to Jordan Walsh. They sniffed it out. Jordan Walsh breaks a tackle. Jakes takes it up. 15, 20.
Oh, yes.
30, 40.
Might be gone.
He's at the 30, the 25. There goes Jordan Walsh for a touchdown.
He's gone.
That would be
Jordan
a
Walsh!
63-yard touchdown.
Touchdown, Vikings!
When Jordan Walsh gets the ball in the open field, anything could happen. I thought St. Pat's actually did a great job containing, turned it inside to his friends, but Jordan was able to, you know, get around the corner again, and he was gone.
Dare I say, after the block punt and the miscue for the touchdown, they've come out, they dropped the first one, but they think they've answered that block punt.
Yes.
With enormously, with a play like that. There's kind of like back-breaking. Just a small little screen,
yes.
And he turns into a 63-yard run. Josh Graham with the extra point as well.
Josh
brings
Graham
it
with the extra.
14-7. 6 minutes and 32 seconds left in the second quarter in this senior championship game. Were you surprised that a Chatham team didn't make it to the championship game?
No, you know what? The last couple years, Northern has represented Sarnia, and deservedly so. Chatham football might be a little bit weaker. We had Walsburg, who's won the championship the last 3 years, and I know Rob probably felt that that group of players probably wasn't his strongest group that he's had in the past. He's got some young guys that are going to grow into it. I think some of his better athletes were maybe grade 11, so they weren't quite ready. Pines had a stronger group to start, ran into some injuries, so tough situation for them.
It was 6:30. Period. It's a first or second quarter, first half. Josh Graham kicks it short.
Oh,
muffed it around there.
Slow
picked up.
Down. To hold on to that ball. Yep, he did.
Tackled there. Should have let it go. Shouldn't even have touched it. Should have let the return man pick it up.
Right.
It's interesting. I was going to say that time I've ever saw the Chatham football, they seem to be more of a throwing league. They seem to have more the better receivers. They have more setup. They don't really run the ball as much. I know Blenheim really pounds the ball with a couple of their big running backs. But other than that, the schools I've seen really threw the ball a lot more than we throw down here.
Yeah, that's a good point. And, you know, with the eight-man football for that group, we lost a couple Chatham teams. McGregor and Blenheim played eight-man instead.
Josh Elsey with the read option off to the left side. Gain of about 8 yards. Forward progress is going to give him about an 8-yard gain.
Josh Elsey. Yeah, great run there by Josh. Very patient. Watched his, I think he had two guys pull and followed them very well. And you knew a matter of time that they'd be going back to Josh Elsey there on a run.
They have to, because that's what got them on the board. They moved the ball down. This had some miscues down there, which turned it over.
Yes. Yeah, and it's interesting, you know, in Northern there, like you said, we're a bit on the ropes after the block, after the miscue there off the first play.
I think they rebounded like a good program would rebound after something like that. And some teams would take a little bit longer to rebound, and they didn't. They come up with a big stick.
Yep.
Read option again by Josh. Josh gets the first down and runs for about 7 or 8 yards.
Yeah. He looked like
Josh. Ramon Bastillo on the tackle, as well as Niles Cruz.
Looks like Josh is taking control of this game. Not sure if it was a planned play or if he just read it himself, but obviously it was the right play. It got another first down.
Very much so. So are you a fan of three-down football? Because I don't like three-down football. I know it's Canadian. I'm not really a three-down football kind of guy. Again, your league down in Chatham, a throwing league, that kind of stuff, three-down football is good. Here's more of a running league. We had to get used to three-down football. For a long time, we didn't have three-down football.
Yeah, I think with Sarnia being so close to the
Josh
States.
Josh Elsey drops back, looking for a screen, throws it up the middle. Oh, incomplete pass. Incomplete pass.
Yeah.
That ball hit the turf.
A great throw. You know, probably
tried to sell it.
He did.
It'll be second down.
So you are a fan of three-down football.
I am a fan of three-down football. I think it's a great thing. Obviously, we have our Cougars travel, and we're in the OFC, and I'm a great proponent of it. I know Sarnia, closer to the States, closer probably to NFL and college football in the States, which is four-down football.
We've always played Canadian rules. We've just always had that extra down, right? Bigger field, extra down.
Sure. Yeah, I think we'll argue about it a little bit here today. But, no, I do love the three-down football, and it does get teams to be a little bit more creative.
Read option red there, going nowhere. Tackle right there by Josh Snow.
Quarterback Elsley sacked in the backfield by Josh Snow of the Vikings.
A loss of about 4 yards on the play. Josh read that and come in and tackled Josh Elsley.
Yeah, and Josh Elsley is getting off a little ginger. He looked like he might have been winded after the last run, and hopefully he's okay here.
Mitch Humby comes in after coming off of the oxygen tank. He's going to come in and do the punt. Mm-hmm. Back to receive the kick is going to be Niles Cruz.
And Josh Snow there, he just read that extremely well and made no
mistake.
Seems
that they only
got
the read option left, read option right. So once they get
that figured out, yes. You can see that Snow was starting to keying on that quarterback, and that probably was his assignment.
So Mitch Humby with the punt, third down. We got 3 minutes and 56 seconds, and almost blocked there. Mitch had to hustle that one off.
Looks like he's going to go out of bounds at about the 40.
The ball punted by Humby.
Yep.
Bring up a northern first down.
You know what? For the wind and the whole bit, that was a great punt. Punted it out of bounds, kicked away from their athletes, and You know that Mike Adams probably gave them the instructions to do that. So, like I said, both very well coached teams here.
They are fantastic programs, as we've always been seeing these guys over the years. Like I said, Northern's got 10 of the last 11 senior football championships here in town. So,
and surprised, even though they're sure bitter rivals, the sportsmanship between picking each other up, cheering each other on from both teams is outstanding.
Jet sweep coming this way. Now is Cruz coming around the end. Great tackle there by number 4, number 10.
Now is Cruz, the ball carrier.
Dale Meisner with the tackle. It's interesting, but Niles Cruz was a 2013 OFSA gold medal winner in junior boys high jump as well. So, junior boys high jump.
He got a lot of momentum going around there. I saw how he got hit there, got nicked up. But you know what? He's a tough kid. He's going to be up, and he's going to be ready to go here in this play.
These talented kids are just talented in every sport that they touch, which is just incredible. They just jump from sport to sport to sport, be it football, lacrosse, hockey, track and field. Kobe with the ball rolling out to his right with the pass.
Pass intended for Easton.
Claudie goes incomplete.
Yeah. Brings up a third down, third and 5.
Well, I look like Lundy put a little bit of mustard on that one for sure. And it's cold out there, so ball's thrown a little low and deflect off his hand. And fortunate for Northern, St. Pat's didn't pick that up, because probably only been about 2 or 3 players there could have went for a touchdown.
I think Easton Kaladi might be dropping back for the punt. No, here comes Josh Graham. They're going to be punting. Trevor McEwen is back to catch the ball for St. Pat's Irish. Timeout, Northern. We got a timeout, Northern. With we're inside the 3-minute warning anyway for the half. 2:51 left. So what do you expect moving forward? What are your thoughts right now, being only 14-7? Is that in favor of which program?
You know, I think Mac Adams has to be happy with the score and the outcome right now. He's possibly going to get the ball back here with just under 3 minutes. They've been able to show, signs of moving the ball, St. Pat's. And, like, with that big old line, they just need a crease, and they got some athletes that can take it. So I think Northern has to be thrilled. They got to make sure that this ball's punted, catch this ball in the air, hopefully get the ball maybe in the midfield, and then they have like just over 2 minutes to do what they can with it. Hopefully Elsley is feeling okay. He's on the sidelines right now. He's been playing both ways. But if he's okay, then they got a chance here.
Here we come. Trevor McEwen is back to catch the ball. Mitch Damchak is the up back here in case he's a short kick, and Josh Graham is to make the kick. Ball is gone. There we go. The extra protection kick. Left inside.
Right down the middle.
Trevor McEwen at the catch.
We got a wall here.
Gets it at the 40. Takes it up to the 45. Nice stick there.
Nice tackle.
Fantastic tackle.
Trevor McEwen with the...
But number...
McEwen.
Vince Hamm with the tackle.
Vince Hamm,
yes.
I think in a situation like this, this is playing right into Irish's hands, because they're not... This might sound horrible, but it's still within reach. It's only 14-7. In a sense, it might be a victory for them.
Yes.
Due to the other games they've had against them being, 23-0 and 49-10.
Right.
Being 14-7, this close to half is a win, and it's a situation of just a couple more mistakes.
Yep. I think everyone knew this is going to be a good game, and St. Pat's, I think, have to be happy.
Josh Elsley drops back over the middle. Oh. Bad pass. Pass behind Trevor McEwen. Pass behind Trevor McEwen for an incomplete pass.
Yeah, now, looking at Josh's mannerisms, it looked like, he was open. Don't you sit and stick in the middle. And he continued to go maybe into coverage. So
zagged when he should have zagged, I guess you could say there.
Absolutely.
With 2:36 remaining in the first half here, 14-7. We're coming up second down and 10 for the Irish here in LKSSAA championship senior
for
football.
Greg Roberts here to see if he's going to get out some.
Josh with a rollout. Going to come down. The catch was caught by Mateo.
Elsley's pass complete to Tisoni.
Nice catch. He's going to come down in bounds. I don't know about that call being called the reception.
It looked like he got his feet in.
I don't know.
Right on the northern sideline, I'm sure that
veteran coach Rick Allen doesn't look too happy about that.
I think he had some choice words for him, but
I think Rick Allen has been around since 19 30 coaching Northern?
I bet he has. He was around when our CCI team came and lost them in a Swassa game. So
I think Rick's part of the paint at Northern. Mitch Damchuk off the left side, taking it around the corner. Nice tackle there by number 6, Cody Jones. Drags him down for a good gain, though. Second and 5.
Nice crafty run there by Damchuk. I thought it was a nice play. Bounced it outside, and Northern speed did kind of come down and chase him down. So got a good 4 yards on it.
2:21 remaining in the first half here at the Senior Boys Championship for 12-man football. Here at historic Norm Perry Park.
Yes.
The field looks pretty damn good. Alex Field at Norm Perry Park. Josh Elsey with a rollout to his right. So over there looking for. On the reception right there, number 4, Jay McCauley with the reception.
Yep. Next with Jay McCauley.
For a first down for St. Pat's Irish.
Nice play there. Nice play design there by Dave Elsley. I think he had a nice design. It was a boot pass, quarterback rolled, hit the ball very well, and found his man in the flats.
They seem to be very safe plays as well.
SSAA championship.
You know, in the games that I have seen, Northern brings a lot of pressure in the middle. Will have their safeties over top. Their DBs usually play a little deeper, but they usually will give up the flats. And that sometimes is a tendency that good defenses will do.
And the ever dangerous, Mitch Damchuk up the center for a gain of about 7 yards. The ever dangerous, who's floating around there playing safety for Northern, is Ramon Bastille, number 1, who can pick off passes and go back the other way.
Walsh in on the tackle.
Or usually catch anybody.
That is a nice tackle there by Walsh, but a beautiful run up the middle there by Danzler.
Worst case scenario, get a couple more yards here and get out of this the first half being down 14-10.
Right.
Or best case scenario, could be 14-14, which is great, fantastic, right off the bat, I think, for St. Pat's, who's came into this game with a great game plan.
Sure. They both have. I think it's a nice play there. A great run there again.
Josh Elsey with the rollout again. Quite possibly looking for McCauley.
Uh-oh.
Going to let it go. Intercepted down there by number 12, Vince Ham.
Intercepted by Vincent Hale.
That's one of those things we just got done talking about, how safe the plays were. In a play like that, Josh had ate it, threw the ball away instead of throwing up a turkey.
Yes. And, yeah, I'm sure Josh loved to have that back. Yeah, he probably could have threw it out of bounds. I'm not sure if there was someone in the flats, but... And with that field goal kicker, and if they were to execute that purposely, they would have probably only been down by 3, possibly.
So what do you think? Do you think they're going to take a knee here? Do you think they're going to try to put that final nail in that coffin? Because if any kind of a score by Northern with under a minute left here in the first half is going to be just a backbreaker for the Irish.
Yeah, I'd be
Looks
surprised
Looks like they are going to take a knee.
I'd be surprised if Davies takes a knee. I think
he's
going to try to get
it
to his player, his athlete, Walsh.
Here comes Colby Lundy with the read option.
Yep, very safe.
Keep it in his hands.
Yep, absolutely.
Gain of about 8.
Lundy takes it himself.
I don't think there was any reading there. I think that was called from the sidelines.
Mm-hmm.
Quarterback is going to keep this ball.
31, Tyler Jackson.
And a nice play there by Lundy.
8 yards on the play. It'll be second and 2.
The coaching staff is very veteran on the Northern side, but, I mean, they're not used to being a game this close to a team that they've normally been dominating over. So... In any other situation, that probably would have been the automatic thing to say, I'm going to take a knee, I'm going to get out of here, squint in the box, down by whatever. But this is really close. They don't want any kind of a turnaround like that block punt that went all the way back for a touchdown.
Right. Yeah, I'd be very surprised if Jordan Walsh is not in the plans here, unless they just keep it with a quarterback just to be safe. But
Well, keep him with the safe. It's interesting. We're not talking about like a player of that's going to keep it safe for 10, 15 yards. Kobe can break it, and Kobe is faster than anybody.
Yes.
So I think he's the most dangerous person to know that the ball's being stayed with. The only good thing about that is St. Pat's can now key on 5, knowing 5's going to get it. 5's going to get it. Kobe's going to get it. We're not going to do anything else. Let's key on Kobe.
Yes.
But then again, you're not going to catch Jordan Walsh. You're not going to catch the rest of the players once they get going.
Right.
So I think it's a victory. 31 seconds here in the first half. I think it's a victory thus far for St. Pat's. Because coming into this game, both the games they played were out of reach at half.
Right. Yeah, I think Mike Adams has to be happy, even though I'm sure he would love to have that interception back and like to pound a little more points on if he could.
As we mentioned earlier, Blake Maxfield is still on the sideline. He was the kicker, the place kicker, and the punter for them. Colby with a nice fake. He tucked it on his hip. Oh, yeah. Oh, wow. Jordan Walsh with the ball at the center. I thought Colby still had the ball. So, whoop, sorry on me.
No, great run by Jordan Walsh. And like I said, if
safe
you want to get it to somebody, that's the person. Would you say that was a draw? Looked like maybe a draw play. I don't know.
I saw Colby roll up that side and put the ball on his hip. I thought he still had the ball, but hey.
Right.
So let's expect the same play this time with Colby to keep it running off to his right.
Yeah, not sure. I don't think they're going to throw
it. They might not get a play. This will be the last play of the first half, barring a defensive
surprise
penalty.
Anyone, but, oh, he is throwing Colby it up. Might as well. Boom. Caught
catch
it.
There, 39 with the reception. Nice Jeremy Jones. 0.4 seconds left.
Nice safe tackle there by Elsley. Point four, one more play. Don't think he can reach the end zone with a throw here, but they have explosive athletes and they get the ball in the flats.
They're going to have a play for this kind of thing. They're going to have to something drawn up. Last play of the first half will be here.
I'd be surprised St. Pat's doesn't have four DBs.
Barring a defensive
very
penalty.
Deep back. We'll see here. Oh, St. Pat's is in
the Kobe's going to spread them out.
Yep. A lot of motion.
Could be a quarterback draw as well.
It. Look at Forrest coming out fast. He's nice. Got him beat.
Now it's Cruz and with the intended receiver knockdown.
Yeah.
Incomplete pass.
That brings us to the end of the first half here in the first ever LKSSAA football championship here at Alex Field at Norman Perry Park. So what are your thoughts on that first half? I think it's right in St. Pat's favor.
And I look over at Craig Davies, and he's clapping, cheering his guys on, and he knew this was going to be a tough game. He's, I think, happy to be up 14-7. And, both coaching staffs, well executed. Everything was as planned, I would say, pretty well. And both teams have to be very happy with the outcome right now.
They do. I think St. Pat's is a lot more happier than Northern. I think Northern's going to be saying, hey, boys, let's start executing. Their only touchdown is off of a fluky block punt. So we'll see what happens in the second half. So we're going to wrap it up here for the first half, and we'll be back for the second half of the first ever LKSSAA championship here at Alex Field at Norman Perry Park.
Thank you.
Got a chance to talk to both head coaches between the break there at halftime. Unfortunately, Blake Maxwell, number 10, is gone for the game. He is being taken to the hospital. We'll get more on those thoughts a little later. Mitch Humby with the kickoff. Kickoff goes deep. Ramon Bastille is going to pick up that ball back there. It's bouncing. Picks it up at the 15. Ramon Bastille takes it out around the outside. Little throw. Again, there's another unorthodox penalty by St. Pat's. It's going to be a delayed hit out of bounds, which is going to be a 15-yard penalty. That's the third one we've seen today. Second delayed hit, but I had a great time to talk to Dave Owsley, between the one of the head coaches of the Josh Owsley's dad, for example. He's disappointed. He's not disappointed. He's not really excited about the score. He's disappointed about the points that they've left on the board. They've left the points out there on the field and were unable to capitalize on that. Josh wants that back. He made a bad decision. But they feel that they're in that business game, and I think they're able to do it. Here we go with the pitch here. Jordan Walsh gets a turnaround on the other side. Spun around there. Tackled down by number 10. There, Dale Meisner with the tackle there for St. Pat's Irish. It's going to be about a first down.
Jordan Walsh is a very explosive athlete. He got that ball, went around the outside, was patient, and then you saw the explosion when he decided he was going to go upfield.
Craig Davies was the exact opposite. He said He said it's an exciting football game. It's an exhilarating football game. It's exactly what he expected. He said that they've had to get through some, you know, get past some bumps. You know, losing Blake Maxfield was a big thing for him, a key. But he says it's exciting. This is exactly what he thought was going to come. I don't agree. I thought that, you know, but hey, that's what you got to say when you got to say it, which is perfect. Kobe Lundy with the keeper up the middle, grabbed, swarmed in there over a loss.
Nice play there by number 22, number 51.
This might be the turnaround we keep talking about.
John Fazio and Connor Sullivan, beautiful play there.
Connor Sullivan has always been a stud defensive tackle. He's played surgeons. He's played that kind of stuff before.
There is a lot of big push there. The inside linebackers blitzed. But, you know, I am not surprised that Craig said that. He totally respects his opponents and respects what St. Pat's was coming into this game. And I think, he is not overlooking anything.
Are you getting that fancy play again with all the misdirection? Now's Cruz on the inside jet sweep, takes it through, breaks a few tackles. Take that ball for about a 10-yard gain. Forward progress is going to give him. It's going to bring up about a 3rd and 5.
Yeah, and you know what?
Tackle down there by Dale Meisner and Tyler Jackson.
Here's the thing with 3-down football. You get a 5-10-yard penalty. You get a sack. Makes it very difficult.
It opens it up. It opens it up. It does. You know what? I have to give you that. It does give both teams equal amount of times with the ball, I guess.
It does do that. And it's not necessarily the biggest team that always wins.
Again, Josh Graham in there for the kick. Graham with the punt. Trevor McEwen with the recept 220, the 25. Tackled down there about the 21-yard line.
Yeah, McEwen.
They've got to sustain a push up there and try to get some points here. The Northern's been out. They got the last reception basically of the second half.
Yes.
First half. They've got the first one of the first of the second half. So I think that now St. Pat's has got to start moving the ball right now, taking some time off the clock. And you know what? I think this is going right into St. Pat's hands.
Okay, here we go. We'll see if it changes. We've got a
St. Pat's is having their way up front with on the offensive line and defensive line in the pits. Damchuk off the left side, kind of bounces around for probably about a 2-yard gain, tackled by a whole whack of Vikings.
And that's the thing with the Vikings. They're like water. It's really hard to be able to corral them and to be able to get a good, clean block on them. They just give you half a body to be able to block, and they get off the block extremely well.
They do. They're winning the trenches in there. That's very important, I think, for St. Pat's. Coming into this game, St. Pat's. Oh, where did it go in my notes?
Got a full house backfield again, similar to what you see at Western.
Elsie rolls out. He's looking. Grabbed down there by Josh Snow. That's just pursuit and all that stuff. That's just good covers down there. And you've still got Rabo Mastello down there, number one, playing safety, roaming around there. Josh doesn't want to throw it away because that's what they talked about at halftime. And they wanted that last drive down there when he threw that interception away. They wanted that back. So at least Josh held on to the ball when he didn't have a good pass.
Yeah, just watching the two Elsleys there, coach and son. Quarterback, they're having a chat on the sidelines. I'm not sure if they got the right play call in. There might have been a chance for the ball thrown at the flats, but maybe not worth it.
Mitch Humby with the punt.
Nice punt.
Now Cruz with the reception. Oh, picks it up over top of his head. Fancy pants.
Ooh.
Steps out of bounds there at the...
Out of bounds. Near midfield.
What a great punt there. Sometimes those kind of punts are a little too good because it gives a lot of room for the returners.
We do have a flag on the play.
There's a flag on the play.
I think it might be running into the kicker.
Oh, geez. That would be devastating if that's the case.
I didn't believe that's an automatic first down if it's roughing the kicker.
Oh, no. It's.
We do.
Well,
we're waiting for the call.
See.
Is it roughing the kicker?
I think it's. I don't feel it's a first down.
First down for St. Pat's.
You think it is? Oh. Or they're saying it after the.
I'm not sure. I got a little bit of confusion here.
Oh, no. Is this another 15-yard penalty?
Well, no, it looks like it's... I think it's an automatic first down.
Oh, no. That is a huge play. This is the fourth over 15-yard penalty that St. Pat's has incurred on themselves.
Okay. Nothing to do with the kicker then. No, first down Northern. First down Northern.
Jeez, must have been.
So penalty was against St. Pat's.
Unsportsmanlike penalty.
That is the fourth one.
It is.
That was an unbelievable mistake by St. Pat's.
After a great punt, too.
Colby Lundy with the keeper up the middle. Great. Great tackle in there. Tackled by Josh Elsley.
Great job there by the O-line. The O-line, I would say thick players, but definitely a lot of athletes. And they're getting, technicians in there. That whole O-line doing a great job working together.
Got to throw something for the big boys up front every now and again. They're doing an excellent job as well. You got this little play they keep going with the kind of the quads and the movement and all that kind of stuff, trying to rattle St. Pat's. Colby Lundy drops back. He might keep it and look for that corner. Colby Lundy around the outside, runs to the left, out of bounds at about the 1 yard line. First down for Northern. This is what I talked about. You talked about earlier about the four major penalties that St. Pat's has had. They're now 14-7, had an opportunity to move the ball down to be 14-14. And now we're looking at could be down 21-7, and this could be the start of opening up that can.
Yeah.
7 minutes and 11 seconds left in the third quarter here. First down and goal at the 1 yard line for the Northern Vikings.
Yeah, let's see what they're going to do. Could be a very safe run here with the quarterback or go back to Jordan Walsh.
We got a timeout. Timeout for Peter. Peter comes running out on the field with the water. Peter Rostova. Timeout Northern with 6 minutes and 56 seconds left in the third quarter here. 14-7. First down on the 1 yard line.
Cody Lund looks a little shaken up on the plays. He's hobbling a bit while coming off. Might have got rocked a little bit there on the sidelines. He's a tough kid. He's not going to take a play off, though.
I wonder what he's trying to tell him here in a 14-7 game and some great runs. As they kind of like flip a coin in the huddle, you can kind of pick whoever you want to give the ball to.
Yeah, it looks like a one-way conversation. Craig Davies, I think, has got things figured out. He knows what he wants to do.
All right, well.
Well, I'd be surprised if they put the ball in the air.
I was very questioned. What do you think the St. Pat's coaching staff's telling them?
Yeah, this is a crucial goal line stance here. If they're able to get a turnover, maybe back them up and get a blitz. I think they have to be blitzing here. They have to kind of turn the luck on their own. They can't just hope.
I know the coaching staff was telling them earlier, or between the games there, between the first and second halves there, they're talking about the fact that they got to play a perfect game against Northern to beat them. So they haven't been doing that with those penalties. Pitch to Jordan Walsh off the right-hand side. Touchdown, Northern Vikings. Jordan Walsh on the touchdown.
Yeah, great technique there with the O-line there. It looked like a little bit of zone blocking and quick pitch. He turned that inside, and I don't think he got touched.
Brings our score to 20-7 here with 6 minutes and 52 seconds remaining in the third quarter in the LKSSAA football championships here at Norman Prairie Park on a cold Saturday. Josh Graham again in. Colby Lundy with the hold. Josh Graham in for the injured Blake Maxfield to kick the ball. And it's up and through. 21-7 is your score. 6:52 remaining in the third.
Now this is huge for St. Pat's. They have to answer on this next possession. They need to put some sort of points on the board. At the very least, get the ball in the northern end and keep them in there deep. So this is, I think, could be the ball game here with St. Pat's, and they need to start off with a good return.
They got to answer. They just had to come back and answer. That's the plain and simple. They've had their opportunities. I know the coaching staff talked about, like I said, so many times. They feel they've left points on the field, which is bad. You can't do that. You got to put them on the board. So now they've got to answer this call to try to bring it back within a one-score deal, because if it gets anything anymore, it's going to create too much of a bunker to get out of. Trevor McEwen is back to kick, back to receive the kick from Josh Graham. Josh Graham tees it up at the 45. Again, 6 minutes, 52 seconds left.
Diamond in the middle. Not kick deep. Trevor McEwen on the run.
30. 35.
Ooh.
Big hit. Big hit.
Yeah. Trying to see there.
Tackle there by Eric Grant, number 53, Eric Grant.
53.
Tackle by 53, Eric Grant of the Vikings.
With a big stick here. The big stick.
First down.
You know, they've often said, too, that the worst position to be on the football team, most coaches have always put their kind of, not weaker players, but on the kickoff team. Those are the kickoff players are the ones that are the wedge breakers that are going to go down. They're the ones that get killed every single time. They just run down the field aimlessly, and then somebody just ear holes them and tattoos them, which you got to run your lanes.
Yes.
But it's just, it's such a collision sport with one team backing up to get the ball and the other team coming down full tilt.
Right. And, you know, NFL, CFL, they're doing things that are trying to change the game to allow, you know, to discourage that big hit. From what I've heard, you know, they're trying to maybe, instead of having the kickoff, have the ball start on the 35.
What are your thoughts? It's still a collision sport. It drives me crazy, and this I'm going to go off on a rant here.
Right.
So it's just, there's so much protection any day and anymore about with the quarterback, with the receivers, with the hits,
yes,
with all the rest of the stuff.
Right.
Can you imagine those players that set the ways for the rest of these players in the CFL and the NFL? Do you think they would have any money left from fines back from the 80s and that kind of, where there was head hunting? That's what happened. I'm not saying
right.
We wanted somebody to get hurt.
No.
But
right.
It still is a collision sport. Josh sells you with the read option. He keeps it, pulls it back off to his left. With a flag on the play.
Josh Elsley carries the ball.
Oh, this would be huge.
Looks like they're going to be holding. Holding against St. Pat's.
Yeah, it is.
Tackle made by Jordan Walsh and Austin Cooper.
Kind of how the day's going for St. Pat's with penalties.
The penalty is
this
holding
is
against the
Irish. Three-down football. The last thing you need is a second and 10.
The tough thing they're going to do is when they look at the game tape is they're going to realize that they've buried themselves by taking unorthodox penalties and,
yes,
and kind of on the stupid side penalties, I guess. Backbreaking penalties that they're taking that weren't in the game plan. They were at the 14-7. They were 7-7 moving forward, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just frustrating.
Yeah, it'd be frustrating, I think, for the coaching staff. I'm not sure if that player really needed a hold, but obviously the referee was in a good spot and
mm-hmm.
called it.
Loaded backfield for Josh Elsley. Going to keep it. Pass out there. Great pass on the flats. Matteo Tassoni. Tassoni with the catch.
You know, on that, the first player that came in there for Northern really set the play up. He got the edge, forced the play to his friends. And, you know, you can know the kind of pursuit that Northern has when you see probably 8-9 players in the box.
They flow to the ball.
They flow the ball very hard.
They flow the ball so well, and they gang tackle, and that's
yes.
a big thing, right? They don't leave anybody out on an island. They're going to gang it.
Yeah.
See what I talked about here? If you look at the defense that Northern's got here, Ramon Bastello is, look how far back off the field. He's almost just like playing center field.
Yep.
Just back there making sure he's got to catch somebody or pick something off.
Yep.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Tassoni. On the other side with a pass from Josh.
Wrapped up by Vincent Hamm of the Vikings.
Yeah, and that was a tough call here by Mike Adams. Should he go for it? The ball not quite in the middle. If they weren't to get this first down, could the game be over? He's gone with probably looking at the book and said, you know what, I'm going to punt it.
Josh Elsley with his offensive coordinator, Dave Elsley, is obviously his father, but they talk all the time about football, football, and football. I had an opportunity to coach Josh in SMA, and Dave was an assistant coach with me as well. It was perfect.
Yes.
Josh was our quarterback, and we won that one with the kick, and Josh was also our kicker. So Mitch Humby with the nice catch. Nice
Humby's
punt
a good athlete, boy, let me tell you.
He is. That's what they said to me between back Jordan Walsh with the reception.
Yeah.
Walsh bringing it up. Oh, he got away from. Oh, the quick whistle. Quick whistle by the officials on field. Whoops.
I think.
With the tackle, it'll be a first down for the Northern Vikings.
Great punt there by Humpy. And if there was a mistake that he made, I don't know if you want to kick it to Jordan Walsh. That's, lightning in a bottle there.
Dave Elsey was saying that Mitch Humby doesn't look like an athlete, but he's pretty athletic. And right there on that punt, he had to jump up and catch it over his head and got off a great punt. And, of course, you remember the first half, he picked up that blocked punt and took it all the way back for a touchdown. He said between halftime, he said he was pretty gassed. I had a chance to talk to him. Yeah. Kobe Lundy fumbles it, bobbles the ball. They just swarm on him.
Uh-oh.
He keeps swings. Lots of people downfield. Oh, he had
Kobe Lundy.
Zach Duxilly was wide open if Kobe wanted to dump that pass off, but he was going to tuck it down and take it for the first down of a 12-yard gain.
I think Tyler Jackson might have saved a touchdown. It got him by the shoelaces. Good pursuit by him. And Cody Lundley just followed his blocks again. Great job spinning out of danger and picking up a great first down there. Mm-hmm.
Very much so. So here we got first down and 10 with 4:04 left in the third quarter. Kobe Lundy's looking around with draft traffic.
22.
Easton Kaladi with the
fumble.
Fumbles on the ground. They fight for it at the bottom of the pile. No signal from the officials. Northern keeps the ball.
Yeah.
The
there's a slot around there. I think they had a fullback, fullback and a lineman there kicking out. There was a seal here and a seal there and a run right in the alley. Got a 4-yard gain. Big hit on the end of it and caused a fumble.
All right. Yes, it is. Got 3:16 left here in the second, in the third quarter. Pitch to the far side, Jordan Walsh pitch. Around the right-hand side. He's looking for some daylight. Yeah. Goes to the sideline, swarmed by the Irish on the tackle on the far side. A gain of about 4 yards. It's going to be about third and one, depending on the spot.
We just talked about Northern's pursuit, but there's St. Pat's. They must have had 8 or 9 in the film there also. Good pursuit. Know they need to corral Jordan, and they did that. And he ran out of real estate.
Here comes Northern's punting team. I don't know. I would nice fake punt here, or even go with a run up the middle.
This is a good spot for it. You know, if you got your opponent McEwen down, this is a good chance to kind of.
McEwen and Damchuk back to receive the kick from Josh Graham.
Oh
over his head.
Bad punt.
Look
snap.
Out! Look out! Oh, blocked again. Second block. Miles McLean with the block.
This might be the
big block by number 40.
This might be what St. Pat's needs.
His second block of the game. He got the first one.
There's a flag down.
Oh. I think he's picking it up.
Or he's just waving at the crowd.
Uh-oh. St. Pat's hanging their head. Oh, boy.
This will be the fifth one.
Not an unsportsmanlike, again, it could not be.
Was it?
Too many, this would be the fifth penalty St. Pat's has had.
Too many men on the field called against St. Patrick's.
Makes things awful easy to block things when you got an extra guy.
Makes the block.
Oh, that's a big penalty. That's unfortunate. There all kind of a lot of momentum
there.
That's
a backbreaker there.
That could be. Yeah, we'll see if Northern goes for the throat here. 21-7, 2 minutes, 2.5 first minutes left in the quarter.
Northern doesn't need the breaks, and they're getting the breaks because they're playing the game the proper way, and St. Pat seems to be putting themselves in a hole. So, again, St. Pat's is going to have to move forward with this thing and just wait for another season, unfortunately, to get another crack at Northern, knowing that they made mistakes on the field when they had the opportunity to take advantage of them, and they failed themselves.
Yeah. Now, you know what? I think this is an excellent timeout because after that penalty, you just can see how the air just left St. Pat's. They were very deflated. Heads were down. You know what? He's right now in the middle of his group on defense. He's getting the troops ready, keeping their heads up. meeting with his coaches.
Keep the morale up, right?
Yes,
you got to keep the morale up in a situation like this. They got a second block, punt block of this of the game,
yep.
And there's a turnover on too many men.
Yeah, this is an excellent timeout there by Adams. Excellent. And we'll see if his players can figure it out here. That being said, now you give Craig Davies a chance to draw something up. So
he's
we'll
a fan.
See.
Craig Davies and his coaching staff are fantastic coaches.
Oh,
quarterback draw.
Shoes right up the middle.
Colby Lundy. Oh. Flag on the play. Colby Lundy around the left-hand side. Colby with a straight arm. Pulled down, steps out of bounds at about the six, and then thrown back down.
Large gain on the play, flag in the backfield.
Looked around
like
the area of holding.
Yeah, looked like the umpire saw holding, and threw it with a little malice down on Northern. Can see the holding from where he was standing,
yep.
and that's going to be taken it back.
Ball's coming right back on a hold, holding on Northern.
The call is holding against Northern.
Trying to find a number. One of the few penalties that Northern's had this game.
The 5-yard variety or the 10-yard variety are fine. It's a 15 and longer than that, the big turnovers when you've got the momentum and you get turned over.
Well, we wondered about what the next play was going to be, and was a great play by Northern and taken back by Holtz. Max Protect.
Pick it off. I think he's at 99 birthday.
Great play there, number 10.
Number 81, Greg Brissett.
They're starting to air it out a little bit, trying to put that final nail in the coffin for them.
Dale Meisner showed out his athleticism there, jumping up, and he was step for step with that wide receiver and made a great play on it. Is that Greg Brissett?
Mm-hmm. Greg Brissett.
Yeah. Just two great athletes there going up for the ball, and the defense won that one.
Colby Lundy up under center, takes the ball, hands it up, double reverse. Here comes, it's coming this way. Number seven, Zachary Doxilly. Doxilly, double reverse to Doxilly for a gain of about 15 yards.
On the reverse,
players.
Tackled by Josh Elsley.
Like a pitch reverse there.
Mm-hmm.
Had the quarterback, had another blocker out.
Bring up a third down. What do you think? Third down. Looks like Colby Lundy staying on the field. Looks like they're going to go for third down and four.
Timeout, timeout.
Third and four.
Timeout to think about it.
Yeah, Northern's going to call a timeout here. Like heavyweight boxers here just thugging away at each other.
This stuff kind of reminds me of these timeouts. It sometimes it really irks me when I'm watching basketball because the last minute of an NBA game seems to take so long.
Yes.
Because everyone wants to use every single timeout
that's
that
right.
They're gathered and allowed and yeah. You know, to their privilege. And I'm thinking,
yeah.
Come on, man, you don't need a half a timeout or a whatever timeout when there's like 5 seconds left in the game and
right.
You're down by whatever.
You know, I think both coaches realize this is a huge possession. St. Pat's is using the timeout. Now Northern's using the timeout. Northern would love to, you know, get another score and put this game out of reach. St. Pat's knows they need to stop them here. This is it.
Well, the bottom line is, and it's been used in too many times, actually, in sports. You got to think, if there is a next score, it's so major. If it's for Northern, it's done. If it's for St. Pat's, we're back in a ball game for the
right.
Third quarter.
Yes.
So this score is huge.
Huge.
Colby Lundy just was back out there, started counting everybody to make sure everybody was in here. Jordan Walsh, my apologies. Jordan Walsh counting to make sure they only had 12 on the field. Third down and four. Now, defensive line on St. Pat's got to hold their water for the hard count. They could very easily drop it. Or Colby could also kick it. It's a little quick kick here.
Could quick kick, but it looks like
he's going to quick kick.
There
we go.
You called
quick kick.
Coach.
Gone side players too. No 5 yards. Oh, Josh just got out of the end zone.
With a quick kick.
Okay, we'll see. Could be no yards.
Could be no yards on the punt. Northern also had some players onside for that. So it depends if they've got players onside for the. Let the referees
And Elsley wisely went back and grabbed that ball as quickly as possible to maybe force a penalty.
And the officials are still required to throw the flag, even if the guy is onside, and then they just pick the flag back up.
Right. I'm not sure if he was onside. I didn't think so, but.
Guess they're not going to do it.
I think he came out to the end zone.
Josh got out of the end zone, back to the 1 yard line, and then tackled.
So the ball should be, gosh, I think it's got to go to the 20.
Interesting call. No flag on the play.
No flag.
So the player must have been onside.
No flag on the play.
So they couldn't consider Josh was tackled in the end zone, just bring it out to the, or to the 1 point.
Right.
We're confused up here, actually. So
It looked like he caught the ball in the end zone, and then and got out of the end zone and fell down on the one.
Mm-hmm.
They picked up the flag for
no yards on the punt,
and
the player was onside with a quick kick. Oh well, here we go.
That's a safety thing. That's
first down, Josh. First down for St. Pat's Irish up the middle. Nick Jam, Damchuk. For about a 3 yard gain up the middle.
Yeah, that inside run is now no more. They cannot
under a
run
minute
inside.
Left. 45 seconds left in the third quarter.
Looks like the only play St. Pat's has right now is probably some sort of play action to the flats. And we'll see if they dial this up here.
And I'm not too sure. There doesn't seem to be much urgency out of St. Pat's. They don't seem to be in the hurry up mode at all.
Nope.
Josh rolling out to his left.
Oh, got a guy in the corner.
Nice catch right
there. Nice catch. Nice throw.
Beautiful catch there by Jay McCauley. First down, and he didn't get out of bounds, so the clock continues to run.
Beautiful throw by Elsley, and a nice, great catch there by
McCauley. Not too sure they're going to be able to get a playoff here by the end of the first quarter.
It was a great throw. Great throw. And, you know, remember that back in the day, it was almost like they put that trash can out there about 20, 25 yards, and he threw it right in
there.
Great corner.
Perfect. Josh brings his team to the line. Again, rolls out up the middle.
Nice throw.
Number nine there, Travis Garrity with the reception up the middle.
Travis Garrity.
I think Dave, Mike Adams and Dave Elsley might have figured something out here. They've got a couple passes that's gobbled up a lot of yardage, and it's the end of a quarter.
But the biggest thing with that is the fact that for so long, the whole game, that it's been the read option left, read option right, read option left. So now maybe they're sucking them into the box,
yes.
And now they're realizing that now they're going to spread them out a bit. So then once Northern drops back into the – to start covering the zones and dropping back and getting out of the box, and
yes.
They go back to the read option. But I also think they're realizing they're down by two scores.
Yes.
They're going to have to – it's time to get on their horse.
That's right. That's right. Yeah, no. Dave
this seems to be the first.
Got some things figured out here. Let's see if he continues to go back to the air.
Josh Elsley with the read option.
Oh.
Damchuk up the middle. Enough for a first down, 11-yard run.
This is an excellent drive here by St. Pat's.
Damchuk with the run up the middle.
Beautiful run. They softened him up with the pass, and now they've come back right down the middle of the run.
Tackled there by Greg Roberts from the Vikings. This seems to be they seem to be putting their foot a little bit on the gas, which is great. Elsley again, Damchuk up the middle. Damchuk tried to bounce it out to the outside. He's going to try to force it. Great tackle there by number six, Cody Jones.
Yes.
Only for about a 3 yard gain.
Cody Jones came in, filled nicely on that play. Probably looked like he backpedaled first because he had pass responsibilities deep third, and then he came and filled very nicely.
It's so important because you got to have your corners stay at home on that, because if they pinch in, like they're going to get trapped on the outside.
Yes.
People are going to bounce it out.
That's right. Oh,
dropped up the middle. Travis Garrity dropped the ball.
Yeah,
I think he heard the footsteps going up the center.
He had him open, and again, it looks similar to a play that we saw in the first half. Elsley didn't want to lead him into contact and was hoping the receiver maybe would slow down or hook up into
this
the open area.
This is a big third down, Selwyn. This
Absolutely.
Is a very big third down.
Third and nine. Jeez. We almost wish they were able to just get a few yards to make this a little easier for him.
Josh Elsley rolls out.
Flats are open. No.
Flag on the play. Likely going to be a clip.
Probably looking for McCauley.
Incomplete for McCauley. There back here. The
it's the umpire again. He saw something. See? Looks like it's something from Northern.
It's going to be against St. Pat's, and they're going to decline it.
Odd call.
Yes.
Very odd call there, but
declined.
Must have saw a holding of some sort.
Was declined by the Vikings.
First
down, Northern.
Yeah.
Again, penalties are killing the Irish today.
Yes, penalties and the red zone execution right now. That was a great drive. They were able to move the ball. Three great passes, a couple good runs.
Officials getting gummed by the St. Pat's sideline.
Yeah, number two. I don't know his name, but he's had some crucial flags that he's made against and for both teams.
Here we go, Josh third, Colby Lundy. I'm bringing.
Yeah, I like St. Pat's defense here with the odd man in front.
Keeper off to the left. Colby picks in. Another flag on the play. Going to be a holding, I would imagine, back here against the Vikings. Big gain and tackled up there.
Large gain will be overturned by a holding call against the Vikings.
Brought it all the way back here, so now mistakes are getting to be against Northern. They're going to be start getting some penalties, perhaps.
Like the execution of that play. Unfortunately, there was a holding, but that was coming through here. Let's see. Yeah, 10 yards. Again, first and 20 is very difficult to come back
still
and
under,
throw football.
We're under 10 minutes to go, though, so I think there's going to have to be a turnover very quickly, very soon, for the Irish to be able to get down and score.
See the defense, the St. Pat's lined up in here, an odd man front.
Looks like they're bringing them.
Yep.
They got to. There's nothing. No sitting back. They got to go. Pitch to Jordan Walsh. Tackle there by Tyler Jackson. Oh. Another flag on the play. Some of the players are coming up with some pushing and shoving now.
Yeah. Now.
Josh Snow dancing around.
Tackle made by Miles McLean.
Looked to me like the St. Pat's player went in and was trying to knock that ball to cause a fumble. But from the referee's point of view, he might have saw a punch. So we'll see.
Again, so many of these kids have played together in every sport against each other all the way up through their whole life. Unnecessary roughness.
Oh, he is. He's calling it.
Unnecessary roughness versus the Northern Vikings, or against St. Pat's, I apologize. Yeah.
And, you know,
unnecessary roughness called against
I think
St.
the referee was overzealous there with that flag. You can see he was clearly trying to punch the ball out. And from his point of view and his angle, it looked like he was probably giving him the business, punching him. And I think that was the wrong call.
First down.
The bit that's about 75 to almost 100 yards in penalties against St. Pat's today.
Yes.
Oh, big tackle there in the backfield.
Nice play.
Big tackle in the backfield, 63.
Mitch Humby, the tackle in the backfield.
Mitch Humby is doing everything here today.
Makes up for his unsportsmanlike conduct.
But Humby with the return, Humby with the punts and kicks, high snaps,
second
and
16 for the Vikings.
Probably with that penalty call, probably was a little vex, went across and made a great play. Saw that play before, but made a nice play on there. Nope, Northern in the huddle a little long. Usually that means a passing play.
Second down and 16, 8 minutes and 40 seconds to go, 21-7 Northern over St. Pat's. We got a time violation?
Seems so.
Time violation versus Northern.
Too much time taken by Northern.
5-yard penalty.
It's a loss of down, is it not?
Second and long.
Second and long.
You just mentioned about the length of the time in the penalty that or in the huddle that is kind of a play. They're trying to draw it in the dirt, and it takes too long.
Well, I don't think anyone would be surprised if we see a screen pass, and I would see possibly a screen pass to Jordan.
Jordan Walsh up the middle. Bounces. Oh, he fumbles the ball, guts it back. ripped. Jordan Walsh will not go down for a five-yard gain.
Fighting for yardage.
Jordan Walsh has incredible balance and very low to the ground.
Brings up a third and long.
Is excellent.
Be third and long.
And good thing St. Pat's, you know, had a gang tackle there because the it was
just
the last guys got him.
McEwen back.
Damn, Chuck just did it. He went and counted all the players to make sure we're okay. We got 12 players. They give the thumbs up to the sideline. We're good to go. Now let's see if they can get the third punt block of the day. Josh Graham back to snap. Back, look out. Gets it off, though. Trevor McEwen back there. Oh, there we go. Picked up by, McEwen. Trevor McEwen around the far side, looking for the sideline. Ooh.
McEwen feels the punt.
Now his cruise comes in like a cruise missile there.
McEwen, when he gets that ball, it looks very dangerous. And he reverse field, and he seems like he's just, you know, one hand away. That's usually slowing him down from making a big play.
Josh Elsley gets the call from his dad, Coach Dave Elsley, and let's see what happens. A good turnover there. They didn't get any points, didn't give up any points. We got 7 minutes and 46 seconds left in the game, fourth quarter here. Again, we talked earlier about the score. It's going to have to be the next one is key. St. Pat's needs it. Josh with the screen. Picked up off his shoelaces, a la Franco Harris. 31, Tyler Jackson with the catch.
That was a great catch because that ball had a little heat on it. Caught it with a shoe on his shoelaces and still was able to fall forward here for a good seven.
Second and three for the Irish.
The flats are open, but it's a dangerous pass, a very dangerous pass. And I think Northern's willing to give that up so that they don't give up the deep pass. Little cat and mouse, little tic-tac-toe here from offense and defense.
Let's see what St. Pat's has in their read option. Didn't even put it in. Keeps it. Yeah, I'm not too keen on leaving your feet, but oh well, we want to try to get as many extra yards as you can.
This Elsley is a gamer, boy. I tell you, that was a great play there by Cooper, Dave, very fortunate that they ran the ball away from the overloaded blitz and found a hole. And he's not sliding.
No, he didn't even stick that in there for the read option. He was just keeping that all the way because he wants to make sure the ball's in his hands.
Yes.
First down and 10. Fake jet sweep, the damn chuck. Elsley. Oh, they're going to get another flag. That could be a horse collar. That could be a high tackle.
Let's see what happened there.
Met by Cooper.
Josh seems to be getting the tar kicked out of him this particular drive.
Now, Josh, that was that play there. You know, he's a gamer, and 15-yard
penalty.
He probably would have been better off to hand that ball off, but it worked out for him. Had two or three players corral Josh, and it looked like it was a horse collar tackle.
First down, Irish.
Those mistakes are normally St. Pat's has been running off this game.
Yes.
So it's interesting. Like I said, we got 6 minutes to go in the fourth quarter here. Big score here. This would be huge for St. Pat's.
Yeah. Uncharacteristic penalty here.
So ourselves with the jet sweep to Mitch Damchuk.
Yep.
Damchuk cuts it up inside. And he might be gone. Damchuk's going to hold on to that ball for first down, gain of 15.
Has enough for the first down.
And Dave Elsley went back to the same play because he saw that it was open. He's like, hey, hand it off this time. There was lots of blockers over on
that
side.
This is the urgency I thought I'd see in the third quarter, though.
Yes. Well, this is where St. Pat's has had their troubles.
Yeah, that guy, once he gets his stride, heads up. He's a blocker now.
Josh Elsley with a keeper up the middle.
He takes it himself on the keeper.
We're going to bring up a second down in about 5 yards.
This could be the ball game here. They get probably two downs to score. They need to score. 5 minutes left. Got some momentum. St. Pat's needs to bang this in. They've struggled in the red zone.
They have.
Second down from the 7 yard line.
Second quarter there when they threw that interception was kind of a backbreaker. Hopefully they can answer for it right now. Mitch Damchuk.
Oh.
Grabbed right there by 61. 61, Noah Cavery.
Greg Roberts read that perfectly and came over, tried to go for the kill shot, I believe, and missed the tackle.
So third and one.
Uncharacteristic for Greg Roberts, excellent middle linebacker for Northern.
4 minutes and 20 seconds remaining. We have a huge third down.
This is it. This is a huge play. I'd be very surprised if Elsley is not taking this ball.
Let go. Keeper, touchdown, Josh Elsley.
Josh Elsley.
Touchdown, Elsley.
Touchdown.
A little bit of a high snap, a little bit of pushing and shoving afterwards as well.
I think everyone in the building knew that Josh was going to keep that ball. He put his shoulders down and just trucked kids into the
Not too keen on Humby coming off the bench that quick, although he's the kicker.
Yes. Great play there. Great blocking also, and a great surge. 4 minutes left in this game. This is the game again.
Austin Cooper seems to be down on a knee. That's Austin Cooper there for the Vikings. I was quite surprised there wasn't a timeout call before that last third down play. We're going to get an onside kick coming up, do you think, or are they going to kick it deep?
Jeez,
their defense has been playing really well because Northern hasn't been clicking with the offensively in the second half at all. They haven't scored.
Right. That's a good point. Well, you know what? Three down football, coach. This is where I think you probably want to kick him deep or to get a couple bounces and try to pin him deep.
Interesting. Craig Davies goes on as a trainer this time, says something to them. Look out. Blocked.
And blocked. Oh.
That's a huge block.
That's a huge play.
That was a great block there.
That is a huge play.
Mitch Humby's back gumming everybody as well.
Just over 4 minutes in regular time in favor of the Vikings.
And Northern seems to understand the opportunities and situations in a game. They came hard for that, and there was no one that was going to stop a pass at all. They were gunning, ears pinned back to block that. Yeah, absolutely they did. And that was a huge play and a huge point.
Well, it's going to be setting up something for us in the future. It could be coming up with a two-point conversion sometime soon in that situation, right? They're going to try to get that point back.
Yes. That would have been pretty gutsy. St. Bats did that, but in hindsight, obviously, it's a lot easier.
What's interesting in this is Kobe Lundy's back to take the kick. Now, chances are they're not going to kick it deep, but he's there just as a safety valve.
Yes. And Northern's done this all game. They have their guys lined up as if it's going to be a short kick. And once the ball is kicked, then they get into the right position.
Back for the Vikings.
St. Pat's. They got their hands team out here for Northern, expecting the short kick.
Oh, yes, they do. They got their hands team in.
I think it might be coming this way towards this side.
They have to kick it deep. I think they have to kick it deep. There's too much time. Yep.
Nice boot by Mitch Humby.
Now, I'm not sure Kobe Lundy in the middle, but.
Again, Kobe Lundy's a threat, but he's out of bounds over there. For going to be first down for the 34-yard line. First down for the Vikings.
Yeah, Lundy was like a outfielder there. He just fielded that ball and did the safe thing, ran it out of bounds, got as many yards as he could, and ran out of bounds. Smart play. Very smart play by Lundy. And I think a great play there by St. Pat's to punt it or to kick it and try to pin them deep. So that was a great play there.
I'm quite surprised in the situation that Northern was set up like that, that they didn't just pooch kick it over top of that last line of defense, let that ball hit the turf, as opposed to put it up in the air for Lundy to get underneath it with the set of hands that he has.
Right.
I thought they might have bounced it on the turf just hopefully for a mistake.
Yes. Yeah, that ball could have been kicked a little lower trajectory, but I wanted to make sure their team got
Jordan Walsh. Keeper read option. Lundy keeps it, and Lundy might be gone. Number four is chasing him down, Jay McCauley. Face mask.
Kobe.
Referee on this side with a pair of binoculars because he's not going to catch Lundy.
No.
15-yard penalty would be coming up at the end for face masking.
Looked like a face mask from here. That referee was on the far side. It was an AT&T call, long distance, but he made the right call, I believe.
I think that the referee that threw the flag was in the same position we were.
Yes, absolutely. And there, Northern A huge play
for
again.
Vikings, for the Irish.
We got an injury on the play. And that was a back-breaking quarterback keeper there. That was a
15-yard penalty.
And right down to the one. This ball was pretty well on the 30 and pretty well an 80-yard play.
After a face mask call, the Vikings will be first and goal.
So what do you think? 3:33, they're going to punch it. They could punch this thing in. I'd
be surprised if they knelt down. They could try to with time. But you know what? It's only an 8-point game. So I think they're going to make sure of it and keep it with their quarterback. Again, maybe give it to Jordan Walsh and score.
Thank you to SarniaSports.com's Pat Breathauer.
Miles McClain was the injured Irish. He gets up. So Miles McClain, the injured Irish player, is up and he's off.
Journal, the independent newspaper. Thank you very much.
So we got 3 minutes and 33 seconds remaining here in the LKSSAA Senior Football Championship. We have 21-13 as our score. And we just had a huge 15-yard penalty at the end of that long run by Colby Lundy. So now we have first down and goal at the 3. .44 is in the back. Greg Roberts is in the back, a defensive lineman. Oh. Look out.
Some movement. A little bit of movement there. I think the O-line possibly jumped offside. We'll see here. Don't have a good angle. It's on the far side.
It is offside. We're going to back things up. Everyone's getting all excited because he was going to keep it up the middle. So them big men up front
got to slow down a bit. They got to hold their water.
Yeah, they definitely have to hold their water. Look, possibly the right tackle. The only time his name's being called, unfortunately, but and we won't call it actually. So it was be first and 5, which probably doesn't hurt St. Pat's at all. I'm sure they want to take a little bit of time off the clock if possible.
Greg Roberts is the 44 and in behind Colby Lundy. Jet sweep to Jordan Walsh. He's going to get the corner. Is he going to get the edge? Oh, back to the 1 yard line.
Jordan
and he signaled from the Jordan Walsh around the left side, right side.
Great run there by Jordan Walsh. Strung it out as much as possible. Probably took off about 15 seconds off the clock, too. And St. Pat's did a great job there, stringing it out as far as possible and got a good hit on him here on the sideline.
Second and goal.
Inside 3 minutes.
Well, we're back in that same spot again. I'd be very surprised if it's not just a quarterback running it here.
Greg Roberts up the middle. Bounces. Greg Roberts trying to get in the end zone. Being pushed. Stood up by the stand by the Irish.
Greg Roberts.
Nope. My mistake. They definitely did. And they went with their goal line package.
Third and goal.
And Roberts got stood up there by the St. Pat's defense.
Third and goal.
Excellent play
the
there. Taking out big old number 61 there.
Who's that?
Noel Cavalry. So you kind of wonder if this is going to be a play that's going to bounce outside.
Third down.
Boot. He's open.
Oh, bad pass. Good turnover by Irish. Good job. We got 2 minutes and 26 seconds.
Incomplete. It'll be a turnover on down.
He's
Irish. First down.
Of all the pretty things that he's done this game, I don't think that was the prettiest looking design play or executed play that I've seen all day.
Now, it was, you know, it was a boot pass. It balls on the 1-2 yard line. Personally, I thought they could have ran inside. They didn't. It looked like the receiver was actually open, but he had a lot of pressure from the inside since St. Pat's had nothing to lose and they were blitzing. So Again,
it's also
back
a tough time to roll that way, being a right-handed thrower, right?
Yes.
It's really tough. He spun the other way, so he had to get his bearings back.
That's a good point.
So here we go, St. Pat's first down at the one, at the two.
Yeah.
And out of the end zone, Josh Elsley with a pass up the middle. Very nice pass. Travis Garrity with the reception up to the 22.
With Garrity. Robert's there with the stop.
And Northern right now, they got a two safety set. They got a big shell over, and they can throw underneath right now. They got a chance. They can throw underneath St. Pat's, but Northern does not want to give up a touchdown. Got those two safeties back. If we get a tip, it'll be an interception, so St. Pat's has to be careful.
Josh Elsley back to pass it, puts it up.
Oh, the DB's got a break on it.
Picked off by Niles Cruz with the interception of Josh Elsley's pass.
Intercepted by Niles Cruz.
Unfortunately, that might be it.
Maybe went to the well too often. That corner pass is a nice pass. It looks like possibly a nice pass for Northern, but Cruz,
I think something neither one of us has mentioned so far is the fact that the Irish defense have been out there an awful lot for, you know what, they're getting wore down. They're even the just, you know what, they're not that tired, I wouldn't imagine, but they're getting wore down because they've got to come up with execution all the time.
Right. Yeah, that was a great break on the ball, and when that ball is in the air, you can see that there was no one else going to catch that but himself.
Under 2 minutes in regulation now. Northern, first and 10.
21-13 is our score here, Colby Lundy. I don't expect anything in the air. Read option, Colby keeps it up the middle. For about a gain of about 3 yards, Colby Lundy up the middle.
Quarterback keeper.
It's safe to keep it in his hands.
Oh, absolutely. Yep. Again, the goal line, similar play where they did the boot pass and they kept it in his hands to make the decision. He decided to throw it in the flats. Unsuccessful there, but he's going to see a lot of touches here at the end of this game.
Kobe's on the ground again. He seems to be losing his footing this late in the game. That's kind of odd, or just tired. Jordan Walsh with a carry. 1 minute and 33 seconds left.
He has to be exhausted. Cody Lundy's playing defense. He's on special teams. Not sure how much of a break he's getting. So, nice play there, Jordan. Just a safe run by Jordan Walsh. Looked like he picked up.
Josh Graham is in for the set up for the field goal.
Oh. If they are able to get a single or just kick it through, then that might put a wrap on this game.
Lining up for about a 26-yard field goal. Up and good.
And good.
And right through. 30.
Field goal by Graham.
Flag on the play. Flag on the play. There's a flag on the play, though. Let's see what this flag is.
Uh-oh. Flag down on the play, however.
Irish are clapping, so chances are it's going to be illegal procedure.
Holding.
There's a hold against Northern.
That's an interesting call.
Well, they got to back them up five.
Looked like the execution of that field goal was spot on. Great snap, great hold, kick.
I thought that, the field goal was waved off then. I thought that it would look like they were waving off the penalty, declining the penalty, which would make no sense.
Nope. So they're going to try it again.
Why not? We're going to back it up and give it a try from about the 36. Up, yep, and
like
he's got the
again.
Length, and he's got
good.
Another vehicle, and no flags.
Time to charm again for Graham.
No flags on the play. That's going to make it 24-13 with 1 minute and 11 seconds left in the game.
13.
Yep, and, you know, people are questioning maybe that they should have just punted it to try to get that 1 point, but he kicked that first one so good. I think Craig Davies just said, you know what, let's try to do that one again. He can kick it from...
What's needed is a lot of execution at practices with that the exchange between the center, the holder, and the kicker. Yep. That stuff's got to be just developed and pounded and pounded and pounded and pounded because majority of the games I've ever been involved with, it comes down to kicking. If you got a good kicker, you're comfortable with your kicker, you're laughing.
Yes.
It opens up a lot of options for coaches.
Yeah, that was a great kick. Great execution there in the cold.
Josh Elsley brings his Irish out with 1:11 left. Pitch out. Matteo Tassani. Pulled down. Ooh, not too sure. They're going to call a horse collar on 39. I'm not too sure Jeremy Jones got a hold of the horse collar. I think that was more of the sleeve.
No, that is not a good call. That was a that was a higher tackle, but it was.
Oh, no flag. Okay, they're going to pick it up.
And
good call. Good non-call.
Good non-call. Yes, I do think it was, because he did not grab his horse collar.
It'll be second and four.
That's when you can get together and you can get things gone. Josh Elsley, damn, chuck up the middle. Enough for a first down, depending on the spot. According to
the chain
side
moving.
Judge, looks like his first down.
Tackle made by Josh Snow.
Ooh. First down.
I think he's first down.
They're going to give it to him. First down and 10.
St. Patrick's first down.
A generous spot in a 24-13 game. Under a minute, 56 seconds. Josh keeps it. Josh Elsley at the center.
Yep, nice play there by Josh.
For about a 10-yard gain again. First down.
First down.
Josh is a warrior here, I tell you. He's hobbling and limping.
Of the Vikings.
Same with Lundy. Lundy's in the same boat. They're putting all they got in this game.
Josh Elsley back with the very nice pass.
Flats have been open all game. And
Eric
there again,
Steves with the reception. What number is that? 31.
There is no third. Tyler Jackson.
Pass is complete to Jackson. That is a first down for the Irish.
My mistake.
We're in the last minute of regulation.
42 seconds left.
Josh Elsley puts it up.
Nice throw.
Very nice catch.
Oh,
I think there should be another 15. Ramon Bastille reception was Matteo Tassoni.
Connects with Matteo Tassoni. Tassoni hit out of bounds, flag on the play.
Especially what's so frustrating is that fence is not that far from that other side over there. I think a play like that is just uncalled for, to be honest.
Very
with you.
Dangerous play. Very dangerous play there, but
rough play call against Northern.
Again, if you want to give the benefit of the doubt, he did have to run in. You know, quite a bit, quite a ways from the far safety spot to try to make a tackle, but he should know where he is on the field by the time he gets there.
St. Patrick's now, first and 10.
33.6 seconds left in the game, 24-13.
Watch nine, look at this.
Josh drops back.
Oh,
Bastille almost intercepted it, but got the ball knocked out by Niles Crew, knocked the ball out.
There was a player open, but the safeties closed on that very quickly. Very, very quickly.
Bastille almost got an interception if it wasn't knocked out by his own player.
Yes.
But at the same time, I'm thinking they're very glad that they're not didn't catch that because he probably would have got tooled. Josh Elsley again at the back. Damn check up the middle. Damn check bouncing off some people. Enough for a first down.
I like that call.
First down for Irish.
I like the call by Dave Elsley there.
It is a first down. He knows the clock stops.
He knows the clock's going to stop, so give it to the play that's been working all game, especially with four DBs back.
Score quick here. Josh Elsley, you got to do. He's going to keep it. No. No.
Elsley with the keeper. No gain.
I think I still would have pounded that rock with Damchuk up the middle. Now with 14 seconds left, I'm not too sure they got time to score and onside kick and then score.
Right. Yeah.
But it is Canadian rules, and who knows? We're under 10 seconds left. Josh rolls out to his left. Dump pass.
Oh.
Knocked away. knocked away by 39. Jeremy Jones with the breaking it up.
That was a good play design.
Jones on the scene for the Vikings.
That was a great play design, and unfortunate that he dropped that. It was open. It was open in the end zone.
This could be the last play of the game here. 3.6 seconds left. Josh Elsley drops back. Oh,
nice touchdown. Play. That's a smart play, but that's it.
A little bit too late. Number 9, Travis Garrity on the for a touchdown.
It'll be a touchdown, St. Patrick's.
Wide open. Perhaps they can back up to the 40. What are your thoughts?
Well, you know what? This is what I expected. I'll go right down to the wire, and we'll see if how much this is going to be within, but definitely within a touchdown.
Elsley with a two-pointer. Takes it across the line for the Irish. That is the ball game, folks.
24-21, the final score for the Vikings.
24-21, great game.
How many points did they leave on the board early, which they shouldn't have? They should have been able to get it and get it done.
You know what? I take my hat off to both these teams. I think that was an excellent game. St. Pat's have nothing to be ashamed of. They put their hearts in it for sure. It started to move the ball a little bit more in the second half. And Northern, solid, all key plays. They you know, for the block punt, for the long play there, that led to another score. Great game by both coaches.
The problem I have with it, though, is as a coach, I would rather lose by 30, because then you can't pinpoint something. Losing by 3 points, although the 2 point at the end, you can break down the fact of the penalties that hurt you, all the rest of the stuff that hurt you, so you can pick apart the parts of the game that possibly could have put you over the top. So
yes.
In a game like this, it's much tougher to lose. With a win, though, Northern now moves on to play Herman.
Well, you know what? Again, great game. I think they all left it on the field. No quit in any of these players. And it's unfortunate that there has to be a champion. And so only one team can hoist a cup, because they think they're both, both played extremely hard. But Northern definitely won this game.
And best luck when they move on to their bowl game. So with final score 24-21, I'm for the first ever LKSSAA championship game here at North Prairie Park. Congratulations to the Northern Vikings, and thank you very much, Sal.
Thank you very much, Jim. I really appreciate it.